नमस्कार गर्ल्स, यू आर लर्निंग 12th चैप्टर, लास्ट चैप्टर इज़न्ट इट? इंट्रोडक्शन टू स्टैटिस्टिकल मेथड्स एंड इकोनॉमेट्रिक्स. ऑलरेडी वी हैव लर्न्ड द इकोनॉमिक्स मीनिंग, डेफिनेशंस, लिमिटेशंस एंड अदर थिंग्स. देन वी स्टडीड द डेटास. देन वी लर्न व्हाट डज अरिथमेटिक मीन, इज़न्ट इट? टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन. Standard deviation. So the measure of central tendency, that is average, it serves to locate the center of the distribution, isn't it? How to calculate the average? Either we have two methods, sigma n by x by n, or else a plus sigma x by n. Both methods we are calculating. So they are both method. They help us to get the center of the distribution, but they do not say how the items are spread, how we are calculating the assumed, that it cannot tells. So the frequency distribution, how they are taking the central value or the how the items are spread out both the sides, the lower or the higher. So to calculate that, we commonly refer the dispersion. This is a question it asks girls. So the commonly used is called, referred as dispersion. That is, the degree of variation is evaluated by the various measures. So here we have two kinds of measures of dispersion. That is absolute. Absolute measure of dispersion, and the other one is relative measure of dispersion. Absolute measure and relative measure. The absolute measures, it indicates the amount of variation in a set of values. It gives set of values of items. It describes a set of values in terms of units of observation. Relative, it is free from the units of measurement and abbreviation. They are pure numbers. They help to compare. It helps for comparison. So relative measure of dispersion, it is used to compare the variation of two or more sets, so which having different unit. Here we have the standard deviation. It is one of the method of absolute measure of dispersion. Standard deviation is one of the methods of the absolute measure of dispersion. It was given by Carl Pearson. It's the name of a person. The economist Carl Pearson gave the concept in the year 1893. So in the year 1893, he gave the concept of the standard deviation. It is also called as root mean square deviation. That is, square root of the mean of the square deviation from the arithmetic. So it provides accurate result. Square of standard deviation is called variance. So during the square root method, he introduced the concept of standard deviation. It will be more appropriate or absolute or accurate. It gives accurate result. Here we have positive square root arithmetic mean and also the positive square root of the arithmetic mean of the square is given in the abbreviations, the observation. That is, it is popularly denoted by the Greek letter sigma. usually while we are calculating the standard deviation we use this. This is called sigma. It is a Greek letter. For calculating the standard deviation we have to have calculate the formula. The formula defines the letter A, sigma. The sample denotes S. Okay. So how to calculate the standard deviation in individual series? Deviations taken from actual means and also deviation taken from the assumed means. So in both the method we can calculate the standard deviation. Standard deviation can be calculated by actual and also assumed mean. So usually it denotes the word, this is sigma. So from two methods we can calculate, one is actual mean, the another one is assumed mean. So if you want to calculate, the formula of standard deviation is equal to root of standard deviation formula is equal to root of sigma x minus x bar squared by n. Okay, the whole square root of sigma x minus x bar square by n. So here x bar means value of distribution, n already we know number of observation. So how to calculate the standard deviation? First you have to find the actual mean, then each value you have to subtract x minus x bar, then you have to calculate the square deviation sigma x square, then it should be divided by n, then you have to calculate the root of square root model. So standard deviation sums will be given by Mrs. Gayatri followed by this video. Okay, so arithmetic mean and standard mean you have to just have a thing which is given by Carl Paulson in the year 1893, that you have to keep it in mind. And the word comes from say a Greek letter. It denotes sigma. Usually S denotes the standard deviation. So he calculated concept, he brought the concept through the square root system. These things you have to keep it in mind. So this video followed by the video of sums. Okay, so try to understand the sums.